Hi, I'm Karen McKee, and welcome to my channel. If you are new, I hope you'll consider subscribing so you don't miss something that may help you get your paper published. For returning viewers, thank you for your support and comments. Since we are starting a new year, I thought I would review in this video some tips to help you become a better writer. You may already be aware of some of these recommendations, but I find that often people don't follow them, even if they know about them. So it's worth going over them again. The first tip is to read a lot. Good writers are always prolific readers. You can't expect to write well if you don't read the literature regularly. Read papers in your field and in other fields. You are not only reading for the scientific content, you are also reading to absorb the way scientific papers are written. Notice how the paper is structured and how sentences are worded. What information is included and what is left out? You should be reading the literature in your field on a regular basis anyway to keep up with the latest scientific research. But you may pick up some writing tips by looking at papers in other fields, especially ones that are considered to be examples of strong writing. Before you begin writing your paper, read recent papers in your target journal. Note paper structure, quality of figures, number of references cited, and technical terms used. You want your paper to look and sound like other papers published in that journal. This is particularly important for journals with paper formats that differ from the typical MRAD structure. It helps to set aside a regular time during the week to read. The second tip is to practice. Writing is a skill and needs to be practiced on a regular basis. Like musicians and athletes, writers need regular practice. It's unreasonable to think you can become a good writer without spending a lot of time writing. So try to write every day. Don't wait until you have all your data in hand to begin writing. You can always begin writing the methods or introduction while the research is ongoing. Select a time of day that you are least likely to be interrupted and spend an hour or two writing. Practice those aspects of writing that you find most difficult. For example, if abstracts are a challenge for you, then try writing abstracts for published papers and compare your version with the abstract in the article. If you're having trouble organizing your thoughts, practice outlining. A good outline provides a solid foundation for your paper. Once you begin publishing papers, continue practicing and improving. The third tip is to pay attention to criticism. Reviewers, editors, advisors, and other people who read your work will tell you what's working and what's not working in your writing. This is valuable input that you must pay attention to. Yes, some reviewers will make comments or suggestions that are not helpful or outright wrong, but most will give you useful feedback. For example, a reviewer may say the point of your paper is not clear. This usually means that your paper has not been structured around a central idea and meanders all over the map. For more ways to identify problems based on critical comments, see the link in the description or in the card above. If more than one reviewer points out the same problem, then you need to pay attention. If a reviewer doesn't offer a clear solution, it might be worthwhile to ask someone else for help. Your advisor or a colleague with more writing experience might be willing to suggest ways to improve the problematic passage. You can also use an AI tool such as ChatGPT to tell you what the problem is and suggest ways to fix the writing. But don't become overly reliant on such tools. It's much better for you in the long run to become proficient at writing. The fourth and final tip is to be a reviewer. This suggestion is for those who are young scientists with one or two publications and sufficient experience to assess the work of others. There's no better way to improve than to read and assess other people's papers. In addition to evaluating the research, you'll quickly learn to spot problems with the writing, which you can then avoid in your own writing. Having to read a sentence over and over to figure out what the author is trying to say will soon teach you why you should avoid making the reader work to comprehend your own writing. Badly written manuscripts can be particularly helpful because they not only teach you what a poorly written paper looks like, they give you an opportunity to suggest ways to improve the writing. So over time, you'll learn what writing mistakes to avoid. Well, those are a few tips that will help you become a better scientific writer. Thanks for watching, and I hope you have a great year.